Welcome to our review of Pirate Tales, a simple-to-learn but engaging game where pirate squirrels compete to collect the best hoard of nuts. Now, I'm going to try and keep the nut puns to a minimum, but it's hard.
Pirate Tales comes from Skybound Tabletop, who we have to thank for sending us a review copy. It was designed by Whitney Lorraine and features artwork from Sonia Henna. Published last year and should be available at your friendly local game store as well as most online stores.
This memory-based game plays 2 to 5 players with games going nice and quick, under 30 minutes, even at higher player counts. That's just for one round, though. We found that most groups like to play this a couple times in a row.
Now, Board Game Geek lists this as a weight of 1, but only one person has voted at this point, so it's likely going to shift up slightly. While the basic mechanics in Pirate Tales are pretty simple, there's thinking, memory, and card counting required to play well. Now, a suggested age of 8+ does fit for these reasons.
So in Pirate Tales, you're a scurvy squirrel looking to amass a hoard of nuts. Each turn, you'll draw 3 nut cards from the deck, 1 you keep, 1 you'll reveal at an island, and the last you will bury at a different island. Now, instead of drawing new cards, you can instead raid the nuts on one island. Round ends when all the nuts on the islands are claimed. Points are awarded for nut sets at the end of 3 rounds.
The component quality here is what you would expect from a mass market card game. The entire game is cards. Just cards. There's no tokens or anything like that. The box has a cardboard insert that you will have to remove if you want to play with sleeved cards. And personally, I found the artwork a bit kiddie looking.
I didn't mind the art at all. It reminded me a little bit of Point Salad. Squirrels won't get scurvy because nuts actually have quite a bit of vitamin C. Now, with that, let's move on to an overview of play.
So place a set of hiding spaces out on the table equal to the number of players. Each player select 2 suits of nuts and 2 candy cards. Shuffle those all together and you're ready. That's it.
Each turn, players have 2 options. The most common action being to search for nuts. You draw 3 cards in turn, 1 at a time, and with each card, you decide what you want to do with it. You keep it, placing it face down in front of you. You reveal it by placing it face up at a hiding place, or you bury it face down at a hiding place. Each option can only be taken once, and the card you reveal can't be at the same spot as the one you bury.
The other option is to raid the hiding spot by taking all of the nuts from one hiding spot. Note some of these will be face up and some will be face down. Each hiding spot can only hold 5 cards, and if all the hiding spots are full, you must take the raid action. Cards collected can be looked at, but must remain in the same state they were taken. Face up cards stay face up, and face down cards stay face down.
The round ends when all hiding spots have been raided. A new round begins with players who raided last getting the first play. Players keep all the cards they've collected between rounds. Game continues for 3 rounds, reshuffling the draw deck as needed.
At the end of the 3rd round, everyone calculates their score. Each set of nuts of the same type are worth points based on how many you collected, with 0 points for 1 nut, your lowest value nut if you collected 2, your middle value nut if you collected 3, and your highest value nut if you collected 4 or more.
Mixed in the nuts are also candy cards. Squirrels love candy even more than nuts, but too much of it makes them sick. You get 5 points for each of the first 2 candy cards you collect, but if you collect 3 or more, you ate too much candy and get no points for those cards.
And that's it. That Pirate Tales is that simple. Every round, draw 3 cards, decide what to do with them. What's that simple statement doesn't get across, though, is how much strategy and memory is required to actually do this well.
It's simple, but I had a hard time getting a handle on the scoring at first. I had Mo show me the chart about 16 times, and I want to print out little reference cards to give to people when we play this game.
Yeah, it's really hard to get the scoring right on the first try. It's not hard, it's just not obvious. I highly recommend taking extra time to explain the scoring again and maybe again during any teach.
Yeah, because you get nothing for 1 nut, your lowest for 2, your middle for 3, max at 4. This means if you've got a 12, the highest card in a suit, but it's paired with a 0, you get nothing. If you also have a 3, now you get 3 because that's the card in the middle. The only way you'll ever score that 12 is have 4 or more matching nuts in that suit. Now, this system also means there's really no reason to collect more than 4 in a suit unless you know you're getting a higher card than you already have, or maybe to deny another player from getting a set. And what I would recommend and what I'm going to do going forward is probably play a single round of the game, score that and then restart, making sure everyone's on the same page.
Yeah, because if I remember correctly, there was someone that was really happy they had six or seven of the same nut, and that's not a great scoring position for you.
Yeah, that was me. I went when I, at my first time at the barbershop bar, I had like all of the eights. I was so proud of my, or all of the peanuts. I was like so proud of this collecting job I did, and only to realize that it was kind of a waste and I got crushed because I didn't have anything else.
Now, another thing that adds depth is the card distribution, which we didn't cover in the rule teach, but there are only 1-0. Then two each of 1, 2, 3, and 5, then a single 8 and a single 12 in each suit. And then there's the candy, right? There's two pieces of candy per deck per player. Well, I'm not saying it's a card counter's dream or anything. It's still pretty light, but you do have to pay attention to what's going on. Like if you've got a 5, there's only an 8 and a 12 out there somewhere. And if you know someone else has that 12, you know, the only better card's an 8, so you can make decisions based on if you should go fishing for it or not. Same thing with the candy, right? You only want two pieces, the perfect things to have two. But of course, part of the game might be to, you know, bury some candy where you think another player is going to take it next turn so that you make their squirrel sick and they get no points for the candy, right? Like there's a lot more going on than you would expect from a simple game about pirates, squirrels, and nuts.
You want to keep track, but you're just making a lot of educated guesses because a lot of things are face down. You want to remember what you've played face down and then don't go and pick up something that you forgot you put there. Or maybe you do want to go and get something you put there. It's a fair amount to keep track of and keep you engaged in the game. But I wouldn't say, I don't think really card counting is possible with that much blind information.
Yeah, personally, I think some of its weight depends on the player count. At the full player count, you are wasting your time trying to pay too much attention. With four other players revealing one card and hiding two, it's more or less a coin flip of what's in those face down cards.
Personally, I think Pirate Tales is at that great weight for a get to know you game, right? Something to kick off a game night or something to fill the gap between games. I also think it's great for public play as it looks super approachable and actually is, except for that slightly obscure scoring system.
I actually think the key to this one is to get people to not take it too seriously. If you're trying to play extremely strategic and try and figure out what every card is and you're, you know, like I said, it's educated guesses. If you can do that and not get AP like some of our children do, then it's a quick, enjoyable game.
I really like this game because I can play it without paying too much attention. Just throw your nuts on the table, chat with friends, keep an eye on what else is going on, maybe plan for what your next game is going to be after you're done playing.
So overall, Skybound is really impressing me with these light card games. We first reviewed Kiss the Goblin a few weeks back, which ended up being way more fun than we expected. And I got to say, Pirate Tales is the same. It's much more involved and engaging than I expected. I expected a kid's game, right? I'm thinking Uno with nuts or something like that. And it ends up, there's more to it, but it's still welcoming. It's still a great welcome mat game. It's still very friendly, family friendly. And I think even younger kids could enjoy it.
Yeah, it's a very family friendly game, but it is not a kid's game or a kiddie game, which, like I said, when I first saw the art, I kind of thought, oh, that's a kid's game. I'm not sure about that. I was a little dubious. But yeah, it's a good game.
Yeah, I could definitely see, you know, at our Walkerville event, that younger family thinking that it's for them when their kids are too young for this game, 100%. Mm-hmm. Even their older child who does play more of the games is not ready for this game yet.
Yeah, we said it right at the start, right? 8+ seems about right, right? Mm-hmm. Like younger players, not little kids. If you're looking for a light, accessible card game, good for a gathering of gamers or a family game night or a pirate-themed game night, Pirate Tales is probably a good choice. It's a welcoming game that isn't quite as simple as it looks.
You know, if you've got people trickling in at the start of the game night, pull this one out and you won't be disappointed because of that quick play.
Now, I'm going to call it one comparison for the experienced gamers, the alpha gamers out there, right? This game actually has some similarities to Biblios and its follow-up for The King and Me. And I want to call this game Biblios Light. Those are games that tend to attract more seasoned gamers. And if you do generally prefer heavier card games, don't overlook Pirate Tales. Like we keep telling you, don't take it too seriously, but you can. You can try to keep all that card counting, keep track and look at what players have faced up and base. Oh, they're burying something there. So I have a feeling based on that, there's no way they're giving away a cashew because they've already got three. You can play the game that way. So don't regard it as a kid's game. There is quite a bit of strategy possible here.
That brings us to the end of our Pirate Tales review. Now I think it's time for a snack of mixed unsalted nuts. While we're munching down on those, why don't you let us know what your favorite pirate-themed board game is? We'll check the comments when we get back from our snack.
Comment here, or better yet, head over to the Tabletop Bellhop Discord at discord.tabletopbellhop.com and let us know what kind of nuts you like there.